Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm in territory that I've never been into before. I'm looking at a band called Styx. I know nothing about them. Well, that's not strictly true. I know that there was a slushy song, I think from the 80s, called Babe, which I didn't really like. Today's reaction is completely fresh. I've not heard it yet, genuinely. It's from the third album. It's the title track called The Serpent Is Rising. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new around here, my name's Dave, and what we do here is we track reactions, album reviews, and occasionally we'll do some track rankings. But today we're in reaction territory. It's Styx, it's The Serpent Is Rising, and I know very little about the band or anything else about it. I know that The Serpent Is Rising is the title track from their third album, released in October 1973, 3 months after their second album was released, called Styx 2. Not particularly brilliant chart-wise, 192 on the Billboard 200. It's their second lowest charting album. Looking at the group members, I can see that Dennis DeYoung was on vocals, keyboards and accordion. James J.Y. Young on vocals and electric guitars. John Kurulaski is on vocals, electric and acoustic guitars, as well as synthesizers. Chuck Pinozzo is on bass guitar, backing vocals. And John Pinozzo is drums, percussion, backing vocals as well. The first thing that hits me is there's a heck of a lot of singers in there, so that presumably gives them quite a variety of singing styles and tones that they can draw upon. Thank goodness for that, I thought it was a blank tape there. Okay. Real rock feel to it. Okay. Fabulous harmonies there, really stepped up. That's quite a traditional prog sound. Guitar solo. Thank you. to that theme again there. Okay, that was different. Straight off, first reactions, genuine first reactions. That is a track that sort of typifies what I would understand to be a progressive rock track from the early to mid-70s. No two ways about that. The sound is very distinguished. It's got shades of Emerson, Lake and Palmer in there through the keyboards. Nowhere near as good as Keith Emerson, obviously, but there was a very strong drive from the keyboards. Talking of Emerson, Lake and Palmer, lead single sounded very much along the lines of Greg Lake when he exploded into his vocals on the ELP tracks. I really did like the singing. It added to that sense of progginess, for want of a better word, that went throughout the track. Strong musically, there was that heavy beat that went all the way through it. We came back to that introductory part of the song and it started off again. Guitar work, and it was okay. It was nothing fantastic. It was perfectly acceptable. When you think of the major prog rock bands, you've got Steve Hackett from Genesis, you've got Steve Howe from Yes, Robert Fripp from King Crimson. Strong guitarists that had a particular sound that dominated a band and a track. Really didn't feel like that. It's the same, it was okay. Bass work, perfectly adequate. Drums, okay, no problems there. It was a good lesson, to tell you the truth. I had not heard the band before. Well, that's not true, as I say. My exposure to Styx is Babe. And that was so not like Babe. It was untrue, but really enjoyed it. So a quick look at the lyrics to see if we can make any sort of sense out of this. It was written by Charles Lofrano and John Kuraleski from the band. So presumably it was John Kuraleski that sang it. Correct me in the comments below if that's incorrect. So the lyrics go, in the abyss of space, from the centre of time, a Superman race moves the serpent to climb. The journey has lasted 7 ages or more, life after life must pass through the door. The secret revealed when you leave your cave is a glory of thunder and life from the grave. The serpent is rising, uncoiling in your spine, bringing you light from the depths of your mind. The people have massed in the centre of town. We drink from a glass and the world turns around. The serpent is rising, uncoiling in your spine, bringing you light from the depths of your mind. And we repeat that sort of chorus. I love playing something that I know nothing about. I love playing things about a group I know extremely little about. Reading a little bit more while the song was playing, many of the tracks on The Serpent of Rising were meant to have a sexual connotation with it. Now, if you apply that to this particular track, then it's quite obvious what serpent is rising and how. But the rest of the lyrics don't give any credence to that, so there's no specific link. Obviously, we're a family channel on here, so we won't delve any further than that. But yes, there were certainly questions asked about the meaning of this album when it was released. So there we have it. Styx, The Serpent Is Rising. What are your thoughts on this song out there? Have you heard it before? What do you think to Styx? My first exposure, if I was to have to give it a score, I don't like scoring particularly, it's a good 7.5 out of 10. I got into the groove. But it'd be interesting to find out what you guys think about it, eh? And as ever, leave your comments down below and I'll get back to you and answer them, each and every one of you. And tell me what you think about Styx. So as I say, hope you've enjoyed today's video. If you have, please give it a big thumbs up. And if you are feeling in a very generous mood, there's a little button down there that says subscribe on it. It's just about there somewhere. Probably about there. If you could smash that and click on that and hit the little bell, that would be fantastic. I'm approaching 500 subscribers, which is amazing. The response that I'm getting from you guys out there is absolutely brilliant and spurs me on to do more of these reactions, etc. Thanks for joining me. Hope you've enjoyed it, and we'll catch you again next time on the Album Review Channel. Bye for now.